Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. So this is a quick guide for anyone who's having trouble importing MP4 files into Premiere Pro. So you're either getting an error message or they're just not importing. So the problem is encoding. So we'll just have a quick look here at some files. So this file here is a MP4 file. So I'll just go to properties. So just here, MP4. This one here is an MP4 as well, I believe. No, MKV, so obviously you know you can't use MKV files. This one here is another MP4, and this one here is also another MP4. So these ones are all ones I've got from different sources, and they're encoded differently. So VP9, I believe, and AV1, and obviously MKV. So if you try to drag these across, you'll get this effect. This one here seems to be going across just as music and unsupported compression. So there we go, AV1. And obviously MKV just isn't accepted. But this file here, the H265, no problems. So in order to fix this, we need to re-encode them in a different format. So you can use any software you want. I'm using a tool called Handbrake. This is the paid version, but I believe they also have a free version. So basically, just find your file and drag it across. It'll do a quick analysis. Okay, so here you'll see your file format, your file name, a little bit of info about it. And down here you've got presets to export. So there's quite a long list. In order to get it to work in Premiere Pro, avoid any of the more advanced ones, so AV1, and I believe there's a VP9 around here somewhere. Anyway, they're the ones you want to avoid, so just stick to the HVEC. So if you want to export in high quality, choose one of the slower options. So I've been using Fast, this one right here, so Fast 2160, 60p. And 4K HVAC. Once you select it, just click start encode and it will encode. It does take a little while, so depending on your hardware, your CPU and GPU will depend on the time it takes, but you're looking at roughly probably 10 minutes for say 15 minutes, rough estimate, but that also depends on what option you're choosing. So you can speed it up by choosing a different one, so very fast HVAC, or you can slow it down again and increase the quality. So really is up to you. Once you've done that, you can drag the file across. So here's one I converted earlier and it works perfectly fine. And now you can start editing. I believe you can do a conversion with VLC and some other tools, but for me, I've found Handbrake to be the best. So that's an option if you want to use it. Anyway, that wraps up this guide. I hope you found it useful. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.